Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 117. The latest development in Twitter was the Indian government has taken another dramatic turn. IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad took to Twitter to announce that the social media giant had blocked access to his account following a copyright violation. Based on the screenshot, Ravi Shankar Prasad was prevented access to its Twitter account following a violation of the Digital Millennium Copyright Act of the USA. While the access was given, Prasad was left dissatisfied by this move and expressed his anguish via threaded Twitter post, explaining how Twitter violated several Indian laws. US technology entrepreneur John McAfee, who created the eponymous antivirus brand, died by hanging in his prison cell on Wednesday after the Spanish High Court authorized his extradition to the US. Known for his eccentric behavior and medios, McAfee, at the age of 75, was a pioneer of antivirus software and indicted in Tennessee on tax evasion charges. He also charged in a cryptocurrency fraud case in New York. Nothing announces partnership with e-commerce platform Flipkart. Nothing Year One India launch will happen alongside the global unveiling. Flipkart will offer no-cost EMI for Year One. PUBG Mobile has partnered with US electric car giant Tesla. The developers have announced that this partnership will bring Tesla's revolutionary spirit and products in-game. While it did not reveal exact details, it is expected that the Battle Royale will get some Tesla cars. Apex Legends Season 9 got off a pretty rough start, with severe network issue plugging matchmaking and bugs galore, but Respawn Entertainment bounced back just as quickly by fixing many lingering issues along with the improving the general state of the server in order to alleviate issues in matchmaking. Next in store for Apex Legends fans is upcoming Genesis Collection event, which sees the return of 4G Season 0 Kings Canyon, which also means Skulltown is coming back. The Genesis Collection event kicks off on June 29, 2021 and runs until July 13th, 2021. Realme, one of the ambitious tech brand that also recently entered the lifestyle segment with multiple product launches, will now enter the personal care product segment in India next. The company will be launching Realme trimmer, Realme hair dryer, and Realme Buds 2 new earphones on July 1st in India. All three products will be making their global debut in India on July 1st. Also, the products are now listed on Flipkart, which further reveals some more information and specifications of each product. The Buds 2 Neo will be the second earphone in the series after the Realme Buds 2, and going by the name, the Realme Buds 2 Neo will likely to be priced lesser than the Realme Buds 2, which is priced at ₹599. One of the two personal care products that Realme will be launching next week, the Realme Beard Trimmer, will take on the Xiaomi Mi Trimmer. It comes with almost the same design and features as Mi Trimmers as well. The Realme Trimmer will come with 20 lens settings with 0.5mm precision, 2 hours runtime on a single charge, self-sharpening steel blade, travel lock, and a low noise operation. The Realme trimmer houses an 800mAh battery on the inside, and it is cordless trimmer with a Type-C port for charging. Lastly, the Realme hair dryer will also be unveiled on July 1st. This will also be the Realme's first personal care product for women. Some of the key features of the Realme hair dryer include the quick dry temperature control, speed and heat setting, 3-layer protection, and a sleek and comfortable design. Realme Book laptop could launch with Windows 11 out of the box. According to the teaser posted by the Realme Twitter handle, not a whole lot is known about Realme Book, other than the fact that it will look similar to the MacBook Air. Realme Book launch in India will be before Diwali alongside with Realme Tab. A teaser image shared by the vice president of Realme reveals that the Realme Book and Realme GT Master Edition may debut together in the coming month. If you see in the displayed image of the Realme GT Master Edition, a notebook that can be seen in the background appears to be the upcoming Realme Book, the company's first laptop. Realme wants to sell over 60 lakh smartphone units during this Diwali in India. Realme is also going to bring the $100 5G phone soon in India. Realme Nexo 30 5G cost you around ₹15,999, and the company thinks it's well priced. Realme has silently announced the Realme C11 entry-level phone in India. A listing of the phone had appeared at the Flipkart retailer site earlier this month. This handset is officially listed on Realme India's website. Realme C11 2021 launch in India is for ₹6,799. Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 exclusive render show the upcoming smartwatch design from all possible angles. Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 specifications like 40mm and 44mm sizes, 580mm and mil STD 810G durability, and Gorilla Dust DX Plus protection can also be seen in the images. The smartwatch was called as Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 Active in some earlier leak. The Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 is expected to be announced on June 28. A new press render of the upcoming Galaxy Z Fold 3 and Z Flip 3 have been shared online, giving us a glimpse of the later devices' updated design and familiar look of the market-leading foldable devices. Samsung has filed a patent for the smartphone with a detachable display that can wrap around the wrist. The patent was filed back in 2018 and published earlier this week. The detachable display could work as a secondary screen that shows time, notifications, and many more. Athena Bitcoin plans to invest over $1 million, that is roughly around 7.4 crore Indian rupees, to install cryptocurrency ATMs in Salvador, especially where residents received remittances from abroad, a company representative have mentioned on Thursday. According to Athena Bitcoin's website, you can use their ATMs to buy bitcoins or sell them for cash. Bitcoin price in India stood at rupees 25.8 lakhs as of 10 a.m. IST on June 25th. The firm expects to gradually install some 1,500 ATMs, hire staffs, and open an office to carry out operation in El Salvador, which in June became the first country to adopt Bitcoin as legal tender. The move takes effect in September. A Chinese blogger named Gu Zhuang, who runs Beautiful Technology, has been ordered to pay a compensation of 1 million yuan for leaking details about a Xiaomi smartphone. In August last year, Gu Zhuang had released an unboxing video of the Xiaomi Mi 10 Extreme Edition ahead of the official launch of the device. This was a violation of the confidentiality agreement between the blogger and Xiaomi. In addition to the new Mi TV 6 series, Xiaomi will present this next June 20th a new television that it has called as Xiaomi Mi TV ES 2022, and that apparently will have a really attractive price. Despite being a television, in principle it could be a quite cheap. As confirmed by Xiaomi through Weibo, the Xiaomi Mi TV ES 2022 will fight to become the best television within 4000 yuan range, that is around 520 euros, a direct exchange from China. Poco is going to launch another MediaTek Dimensity powered handset that is confirmed to launch in India. Poco India last month confirmed that Poco F3 GT will launch in India in Q3 2021. The upcoming handset has now appeared on the BIS certification website, hinting towards an imminent launch. The smartphone had recently cleared TUV Rainland certification, and this handset was earlier spotted on IMEI database with the same model number, confirming the speculation that the Poco F3 GT is indeed a rebranded Redmi K40 game enhanced edition. Over the past few years, we have seen a different camera module implementation on smartphones, including pop-up cameras, flip cameras, and rotating cameras. Now, Nokia has filed a new patent for rotating camera modules on a smartphone. This is quite an interesting one, since it is not a flip module that we have seen on handsets like Samsung Galaxy A80 or Oppo N1. The new patent filed by Nokia showcases a never-seen-before camera implementation on a mobile handset. The patent reveals that the company wants to put a 360-degree rotating camera module in the top portion of the smartphone. Xiaomi has once again increased the price of vanilla Redmi Note 10 in India. The 4GB 64GB variant has already received a price hike of Rs 500 back in April. Recently, the 6GB and 128GB variant also got a price hike of Rs 500 just a few days ago. Now the company has now hiked the price of the smartphone once again by Rs 500. Now let's take a look at the new prices. For the Redmi Note 10 4GB and 64GB variant, now the price is around 12,999, while the launch price is around 11,999. For the 6GB and 128GB variant, the launch price is set for Rs 13,999, but the current price is of about Rs 14,999. Some of the new devices from Xiaomi are reportedly suffering from touch response issues, and the reason behind this issue is not yet clear. Also, the issue is not limited to just one device, but several devices seem to be having the same problem. The talks about the following devices facing similar touchscreen response problem are Xiaomi Mi 11, Xiaomi Mi 10 Ultra, Mi 11 Lite, Mi 10T Pro, and from Redmi we can see Redmi Note 10 Pro and Redmi Note 9S. We have not independently confirmed issue with these devices listed above, but reported indicate that the phone are facing issues fairly recently. That too on a small number of devices running the company's own MIUI, which is likely the culprit. Some users have tried to factory reset their smartphone, but that has also not fixed the problem. However, rebooting the devices seems to be fixing the problem temporarily, but the crops but gain pretty quickly. Xiaomi has confirmed that the brand is aware of the touchscreen response issue on some of the devices, and the company has also added that an update with the fix for various devices will be rolled out soon. Lenovo has just launched a bunch of new laptops. This include a new lineup of ThinkPad laptops that are aimed for productivity and creative professionals, along with a new mobile monitor and its Go series of accessories for people working remotely. The laptops have just been launched and will be available for purchase sometime in August of this year. Lenovo also shared the pricing of this laptop, which includes ThinkPad X1 Extreme Gen phone will be costing around €2,099, that is roughly around $2,500. ThinkPad L13 Yoga Gen 2 AMD processor that comes for €749, that is roughly around $894. ThinkPad L13 Generation 2 with AMD processor that is costing us around €649, that is roughly around $775. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.